Welcome to the Ocean Photography Awards 2020. Over the course of the next hour, we'll be sharing and celebrating the incredible work of ocean photographers from around the world. The images you'll see tonight are hugely varied. You'll see vibrant celebrations of this beautiful blue planet that we call home. But there are also some stark reminders of the devastation we are inflicting upon it.
At the heart of these awards is the recognition that we are one ocean community. Whether you're a diver, a surfer, a sailor, or even a coastal photographer who rarely sets foot in the ocean, these awards are accessible to all. They also focus on the emotional power of photography, our judging panel looking for connection rather than technical prowess, the story behind each image. Photography has a critical role to play in the fight for planetary health, a powerful tool where emotion and information collide. The more we collectively harness the passion and talent that is out there, the more we celebrate people's connection with our wild blue spaces, the more others might sit up and take note of what is going on above and below the waterline. Wherever it is you're watching this around the world, you might say there are oceans between us. Only there aren't. There is one interconnected, unending ecosystem that binds us all together. It is the beating heart of this planet. That sense of connection and community is why we're here today.
Now, before we get started, we'd just like to point out that we are filming this in the UK, which is currently on lockdown. You can be 100% assured that we have taken all the necessary safety precautions here. And a big thank you to MCC GLC for ensuring that this could go ahead today and for doing such a wonderful job of helping us bring these awards to life during a pandemic, both through a beautiful website and here tonight. A huge thanks also, of course, to our partners Sea Legacy and our wonderful judges, Paul Nicklin, Christina Mittermeier, Paul Hilton, Sean Heinrichs, Andy Mann, John Weller and Luciano Candisani. And of course, to Kieran Haslam and his fabulous team at Princess Yacht 2. So, on to the reason we are here tonight. It's, of course, the photographs.
Now, the categories for these awards are themes derived from Oceanographic magazine's own content focus: conservation, exploration, and adventure. Some of the images you will see tonight lay bare the reality of the devastation our ocean is facing. Those images are counterbalanced by photographs that showcase the staggering beauty of ocean life and inspiring photographs of our innate connection with that very same ocean. Some images will make you scream with anger. Others will fill your hearts with joy.
Our first category is the Ocean Exploration Photographer of the Year, awarded to the photographer who most dramatically brings the rawness of ocean exploration to life. A total of 10 images from the shortlist were highly commended, and here they are.
We are delighted to now be joined by our three finalists. So a big hello to Ben, Karim and Florian.
Hello.
Lovely to have you all with us this evening. Congratulations to all of you for making the final round for this category. Three stunning but very different images, a coastal image, an aerial image and an underwater image. Starting with you, Ben, tell us a little bit about your photograph.
I was in South Georgia Island. This is late October last year, 2019. and had a month on the islands traveling around with a small expedition yacht. Spent 5 days at St. Andrew's Bay, where this image was taken prior to this image being taken. On the particular day that I photographed this scene, there was a massive blizzard with strong katabatic winds blowing off the interior, strong heavy snowfall, and massively reduced visibility. You know, to actually see more than 50 meters was near impossible. And anyway, I was wandering around with some friends and came across this scene of these penguins. They were just meandering through the whiteout. So what an incredible scene.
Well, hopefully we can get Karim back on, but let's push on.
I think let's move on to Florian. Hopefully we can get Karim back, but Florian's beautiful image of crab eater seals taken from above. Florian, obviously you've got quite a reputation developed over the last couple of years for this style of photography. Tell us about this specific image.
Well, that was during a trip in Antarctica. We were sitting a month down there. It was late in the evening when we got in a fjord that was full of ice, as you can see, broken ice. There was a lot of crab eater seals swimming in the open water close to the glaciers. We couldn't progress that much. We were very slow, so we decided to anchor in this fjord in the middle of the ice. By the morning, or early morning at 3 a.m. actually, there was a lot of ice drifting by the boat, making the impression that we were sailing. Those pieces of ice were full of crab eater seals. There was probably, I think I count more than 400 passing by the boat during the morning. But then came into my mind the idea to get a drone images, as I knew from the past experience that it will, you know, bring some really graphical images with all the broken ice, and kind of allow me to show how they use the ice in a wider perspective, where you can understand a bit more how they use it to rest after the feed.
Well, it's a wonderfully refreshing perspective. Excuse those small technical issues, but we do actually have Karim still with us on the audio now. So Karim, if you can hear us, please do tell us more about that wonderfully powerful image taken down in that cave.
Thank you. Very nice of you to say. I've been to this cave many times before. It's on the way back from where I go with free diving and swimming with whales in Tonga. But I've never been there at that time of day. Certain times of the day, you get these light beams that cut through. Sometimes there's all these fish swirling around in the cave. Other times it's just these light beams that cut down through. And on this particular day, we had come back quite late. And the way the sun was coming into the cave, it lit up this little rock pinnacle that I've never really paid any attention to. And so my friend Brock dived down and he tucked his foot under the rock and he stood there looking out into the light beams. And as I was watching him, I felt like he was looking into a portal of another world. I almost didn't take a picture because I was just mesmerized by what I was seeing, and then I pulled my camera up and I took a picture. There's so many things that we haven't yet encountered, we haven't seen, and that's just a reminder of that to me.
Well, it's a beautiful capture, and thank you all for sharing those stories. Let's get on and reveal the winner, shall we?
Absolutely.
So, okay, in third place we have Florian Ledoux. In second place, it's Karim Elia. Which means that winner of the Ocean Exploration Photographer of the Year is Ben Crank.
Wow.
Huge congratulations,
congratulations
to you, Ben.
Ben.
Thank you, guys.
Work, Ben.
I love your images. Congratulations yourselves.
Likewise.
And how do you feel, Ben?
Thank you.
elated, to be honest, surprised, you know, when I was seeing the images from Florian and Karim, I thought, okay, well, it's a done deal that I'm not going to be in the first place. So I'm absolutely delighted, to be honest with you.
Thank you very much, Ben. And the honour really is ours. Thank you so much for sharing your beautiful work with
Congratulations.
Us.
Thanks again to all three of our finalists and the rest of the shortlist. Really, really beautiful work.
Now, before we take a look at our next set of nominees, let's get a little inspiration from two British architects who embarked on an unusual ocean adventure last year, exploring the remote coast of Norway in an upcycled lifeboat. Tonight is about ocean stories, so let's take a look at theirs.
Stodig is a 100-person marine survival lifeboat that myself and David, another architect, bought to travel to the Arctic Circle.
It's gone from being something very small to something rather ambitious.
It's half the size of a one-bedroom flat, but we're trying to build two cabins, two bunk beds, a generous living area, as well as all the equipment we need to drive the boat.
We're taking a kind of vessel which is very rarely converted to this use and take it on a 5,000-kilometer journey from the south coast of the UK to the whole of Norway up to Tromsø.
Overall, this voyage should take 4 months. If we wanted to, we could really do it in a couple of weeks. But the idea is that we're going to take a slow adventure all the way to Tromsø.
Beautiful film there. Now, moving on to the Ocean Adventure Photographer of the Year, awarded to the person who has most successfully portrayed human connection and fascination with life in, on, and around the ocean.
Now, once again, let's first take a look at the 10 highly commended images that just missed out on the final cut.
Congratulations to all 10 of the highly commended. And again, we're now joined by our three finalists, Duncan, Jason and Sean, who are going to talk about all three of their images, which have a real sense of magic about them. Hello all, can you hear us?
Yeah, loud and clear.
Brilliant. Yes. Great to have you all here with us today. I'm going to start with you, Duncan, in your wonderful image of those spine-tailed devil rays. It's a rare image. Tell us more about this photograph.
Yeah, well, it was an incredibly fortunate encounter because we were actually looking for whale sharks at the time. We occasionally see them on the whale shark trips, but we saw this activity in the water. I've seen them before, but they weren't taking any notice of us. And it was only later on that I found out that it was courtship display. And it was hard work keeping up with them and avoiding the other people in the water with their selfie sticks. But it was just a non-stop underwater ballet of these beautiful creatures. And I managed to keep up with them, and then three of them. So it was about five or six males chasing after one female. And when I took this photo, two males and one female converged. This is amazing formation right in front of me, literally a few feet in front of me. I was using a fisheye lens. And right after I took the photo, one of the males broke out of the formation, swam straight at me and brushed up against my chest and swam away. It was incredible. It was like I was actually engaged in the courtship. I mean, I've never had anything quite like it happen. I mean, I've had a few wild encounters, close encounters, but that one was so unexpected. And that's what us photographers like, you know, are looking for, the most unexpected encounters. And yeah, it was just mind-blowing, really. Incredible.
Wow.
Well, absolutely stunning image, really beautiful work. Also, Jason, moving on to your image, equally stunning, completely different stylistically and subject matter-wise. Tell us a little bit about your image.
Yeah, sure. So much like Duncan, there's a little bit of serendipity involved here. I was actually shooting some rebreather divers that were playing around in a microbial cloud right where the freshwater meets the saltwater in cenotes in the Yucatan. And out of the corner of my eye, I saw this freediving instructor who was teaching a student. His student would dive below that microbial cloud. And as she was below the cloud, he'd hang out there and wait until she could come back to where he could see him. We're just in this huge space, and seeing somebody just holding their breath in that enormous chamber with the cloud underneath just looks so alien and fragile.
Fantastic. Yeah, such a powerful image. And Sean, last but not least, I mean, your image just comes alive when you look at it. Tell us more about how you captured this.
Yeah, this is quite an amazing location. It's a very remote part of Western Australia. And I actually had the family with me for this part of the trip, and we were pulling into this area. We had a caravan on the back, and I looked out to sea and just saw this huge bait ball. And I looked closer, I could see these sharks going through this bait ball. So I had the drone up to start with, and there would have been 300 plus bronze whaler sharks feeding on a bait ball that was about 800 meters to a kilometer long. Then I saw the sharks started to push quite closely to the shore. So I grabbed the long lens, grabbed my son. We went down the beach and we saw a few sharks getting closer, and there was quite a big shore breaking at the time. So I sort of took a test shot, and the next wave came through, and you know, the sharks were sitting in the way. It basically almost got washed up on the beach in front of our feet. I remember I showed my little boy the photo, and he just sort of started jumping up and down when he saw it at the back of the camera. So that's kind of when I knew it was something special, and yeah, pretty incredible opportunity and something we'll always remember.
Yeah, that's absolutely fantastic. And thank you all for sharing those brilliant, brilliant stories. Okay, let's get down to the awards. So we have in third place, it's Duncan Morrell. Congratulations, Duncan. In second place, we have Sean Scott.
Thank you.
Which means that the winner of the Ocean Adventure Photographer of the Year is Jason Gully. Congratulations, Jason.
Congratulations to you, Jason. Beautiful, beautiful.
Thank you. Yeah.
Beautiful image. I know the judges were, you know, this category was particularly hard, but your shot stood out. That sense of perspective in that cenote. Just tell us how you're feeling now and you know, what this shot means to you.
Yeah, I mean, I'm super stoked to, you know, win an award of this magnitude. I've been shooting in dry caves for, you know, the better part of 10 years, but I only started shooting underwater about a year ago when a friend of mine bought a housing so I could shoot one of their expeditions in Namibia. So it's just been really exciting for me to get to spend a lot of time underwater trying to learn how to shoot in this new environment.
Great stuff.
Congratulations. Yeah.
Congratulations. Positive. Huge congratulations to Jason, as well as Duncan and Sean, to three staggeringly beautiful images. Thanks also to everyone else who entered into that category, and especially the extra 10 highly commended shots as well. Now, it's time for another ocean story. This time we're heading below the waterline to a group of conservationists fighting for the health of their local reefs in French Polynesia.
Everyone call me Tits, but my name is Titouan. I was born on a pure farm in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. When I close my eyes at night, all I see is the ocean. It's my everything. Here are my friends, and this is our island. Basically, it's a volcano lost in the middle of nowhere. For us, it's paradise. From the mountains to the sea, everything here is connected. We are surfers, fishermen, freedivers. Coral reefs give us everything in our life. Endless joy and adventures. The food we eat and the oxygen we breathe. The ocean is our school. It teaches us humility, love and respect for all forms of life. But I'm sure you hear the news. The reef is dying. As we look down at our feet, something is changing. Corals are going extinct. 'Together, we decided to stand for our ocean. We created our own movement, a project called Coral Gardeners. Our first mission is to tell the story of the reef worldwide. We want everyone on this planet to know what a coral is, how important the ocean is. We are planting corals back onto damaged reef, and we have 90% success. We believe we can make a difference. This is our beginning. Join the journey. Take action now. Our dream is to involve all generations to fight for our ocean. Coral Gardeners.
Very inspiring stuff there. Now, we're moving on to the Young Ocean Photographer of the Year, awarded to a photographer under the age of 18 who combines a sense of youthful curiosity with clear ocean literacy.
And it's been absolutely amazing to see such talent and passion for the ocean from younger generations. Now, we shortlisted just three images for this category, so let's chat to the finalists. Starting with you, Ben, when did your interest in ocean photography really first start?
So I had been doing a lot of like portrait work a few years back, but during the start of the whole pandemic, I was quarantined at home and I have a lot of beautiful nature where I live here in Massachusetts. So I thought that I'd give it a go and I just started photographing local wildlife, but that kind of turned into more conservation because I've always had a deep interest in endangered and vulnerable species. So I mostly just wanted to photograph uncommon creatures up here where I live. Yeah.
Well, it's a beautiful image there. Now, Kyla, again, another wonderful image. Tell us more about what inspires you as a young ocean photographer.
I've just always been in love with the ocean, and I've found ways to combine my love of photography and art to show people how beautiful the ocean is as well.
Comes across, and those bubbles in that photo, eh?
Absolutely.
Really fantastic work.
Now, sadly, Cruz can't be here tonight as he's prepping for an exam, but here is his shortlisted image.
Oh, so look at that.
A beautiful shot of a magnificent anemone taken in the Maldives. So having seen all of our finalists' truly stunning and varied work, firstly, congratulations to all of them again for their submissions. The judges were hugely impressed by all three shots, but there can, of course, only be one winner. In third place is Kyla McClay.
Congratulations, Kyla.
Congratulations to Kyla for her beautiful shot.
Beautiful.
In second place is Ben Camerata. Again, huge congrats to Ben for his stunning image. And that, of course, means the winner of the Young Ocean Photographer of the Year is Cruz Erdman. So huge congratulations to Cruz. As we mentioned, he can't be here, but he has sent us this short video message.
I'd like to start by saying thank you. Wow, it's a great honor to be selected for this award. You know, as a photographer and somebody who's been in love with the ocean since they were born, it's a huge privilege to have a platform like this where my photos have a voice. So thank you very much once again, and I'm very excited for what this may entail for the future.
Congratulations to Cruz, and thanks again to everyone who submitted to the Young Ocean Photographer of the Year category, and well done to Ben and Kyla too. There were really some amazing images. Next up is the public vote, the Community Choice Award. As soon as the website went live 2 weeks ago, you started voting in your droves, and it's been wonderful to see such positivity for all our finalists and their work.
So, let's have a look at the five shortlisted photographs. So thank you again to everybody who voted in this category, and of course thank you to our five finalists for submitting their beautiful imagery. There can of course only be one winner, and I'm delighted to say that winner of the Community Choice Award is Tobias Baumgartner, who joins us now.
Congratulations!
Congratulations, Tobias.
Thank you so much. That's amazing.
Now, the public...
I'm really, really, really happy about that.
Yeah, the public loved your submission. Yeah. They voted for your image in their thousands. Tell us a little bit about where this picture was taken.
So I took this picture actually almost in the center of Melbourne at St. Kilda. There's a little pier where this little penguin colony is located, and originally I intended to take an image which was very different to what this is, but just when I arrived there, I found these two little guys there, and they showed so much love and compassion for one another that I thought, you know, I can learn a lot from them. And so yeah, I spent the next 3 nights with them and literally tried to capture this one specific moment. And after the third night, eventually I got it and I was really happy with it. Yeah, it was a really good moment for me personally, but I'm really, really excited that this image reached so many people around the world, which is probably the biggest reward to me.
Well, the people have spoken, and well done to everyone who entered.
Now, before we take a look at the nominees for the next category, let's first learn a little more about our friends and partners over at Sea Legacy. Led by some of the world's foremost ocean photographers and storytellers, Sea Legacy is an organization that harnesses the power of ocean photography like no other. Connecting their vast digital community of supporters around the world with beautiful photography, important stories, and critical campaigns, they create real conservation wins. Let's take a look.
It started with a vision.
After years of working on the front lines as photographers for organizations like National Geographic, we wanted to do more for the ocean. We were looking for a way to give it a voice.
So in 2014, Paul and I founded Sea Legacy. As a small team, we had to be nimble and move fast to take advantage of opportunities.
But time is not on our side, and the challenges we face as a global family, the state of our environment, and the shape of solutions have picked up speed since we embarked on this journey to create healthy and abundant oceans.
So we too have evolved in response to these changing times. Today, Sea Legacy is able to bridge the knowledge gap and bring awareness about our oceans to millions of people around the world.
And now more than ever, we are focused on being strategic about how we show up for the ocean and all of those who depend on it.
We have a small window of opportunity to act. But we know where to go and what to do. And we want you to be a part of it.
We no longer need incremental changes. We need a sea change of attitudes and ideas.
And we can only do this together.
Our next category is the Ocean Conservation Photographer of the Year, awarded to the photographer who most powerfully communicates any of the many perils facing the ocean today or stories of hope and recovery.
First, let's take a look at the 10 highly commended images for this category.
Congratulations to all those highly commended. What a selection of beautiful photographs. Stunning. There. Really, really well done. Fantastic stuff. Now, sadly, Andrea is not able to join us tonight, but he sent us a video where he tells us a little more about this beautiful shot of imperial cormorants.
I'm thrilled and honored to be a finalist in the Ocean Photography Awards. I took this shot in Argentina, in the largest colony of imperial cormorant in the world. The natural geometry of the colony is disrupted by an element that is destroying our ecosystems, plastic. This threat is visible and very effective to communicate the human impact on our planet. But we must remember that there are a lot of other invisible but equally very dreadful threats in our ecosystem. Finally, I would like to sincerely thank the organizer and the jury.
Powerful words there from Andrea. Thank you, Andrea. Now, we are delighted to be joined by the two other finalists today, Matt and Joe. Hello to you both.
Hi, guys.
Hello.
Hi, how are you doing?
I'd love to learn more about your photographs. I'll start with you, Matt. A really powerful image which shows the issues around plastic in our environment. Was it really shocking to take this photograph?
Yeah, there was a couple of us that were there at the time. We were all pretty shocked. Wasn't a nice environment to be in. The particular place we were was just, I've never seen anything like it. Plastic everywhere. It was sort of knee-deep in some places. It was unreal.
It's a really powerful image. For you, what do you want people to take from it?
This problem is real. It's not going away without concerted effort. And it sometimes feels like it's something that we struggle to relate to for like us in the UK. But it is a problem that we can help with, and it's worldwide.
Absolutely.
And moving on to you, Joe, your image also illustrates the devastation that plastic pollution is having on the environment. This is a truly shocking image, and the physical damage that this plastic is doing to the shark. Tell us about the moment that you took this shot and how it felt seeing this firsthand.
Well, it was shocking. We'd spent quite a lot of time photographing other individual oceanic white tips in the area. And they're just the most magnificent animal you can imagine seeing. And then to see this one kind of emerge out of the blue, and to see that it had this regulator holder, this plastic regulator holder really constraining around its neck. It was awful to see. And I felt, you just felt so helpless for that poor shark. It was awful.
Now, of course, it's worth mentioning to those watching that there is a happy ending to this story, because it was removed, wasn't it, by people shortly after this image was taken?
It was, yeah, a couple of weeks after. Luckily, we found out that one of the local liverboard operators and a conservation organisation local to the area managed to hook the shark from one of their small tenders and bring it alongside the tender and cut the plastic free. So it was nice to hear that. So hopefully it's recovering well.
Brilliant stuff. Yeah, powerful.
Well, thanks to all of our finalists there for sharing some more information around their shots, all showing the devastation of plastic pollution on the environment. On to the results then.
Yes.
In third place, it's Joe Daniels for his shocking image of the oceanic white tip shark. In second place is Andrea Benvenuti for his shot taken from above of plastic pollution, which means the winner of the Ocean Conservation Photographer of the Year is Matt Sharp.
Congratulations, Matt.
Thank you.
Yeah. How are you feeling?
I got very overwhelmed. It's been a bit of a funny year and it's a bit of a silver lining to it, I suppose.
Well, huge congratulations, Matt. Well deserved and a very powerful image. Well done.
Yes, congratulations to Matt again, and of course to Andrea and Joe for their three images that display the shocking effects of plastic pollution on the environment.
Absolutely. Okay, now this next award is a special one. We've just seen a short video about the incredible work that Sea Legacy does. Central to that is the Sea Legacy Collective, a group of ocean photographers with a shared mission, the pursuit of a healthier and more abundant ocean. After all, togetherness is amplification. All seven of our judges are members of this collective, and the winner of this next award, the Collective Portfolio Award, will join the Sea Legacy Collective for a year-long residency, working shoulder to shoulder with the judges in pursuit of a healthier ocean. A huge moment for the winner.
Now, unlike the other awards, this award recognises a body of work, 10 images rather than one. The range and quality of submissions was truly staggering. Here are the finalists. Congratulations there to Grant and Florian, our two highly commended photographers. Lovely to see a broader range of Florian's work, having seen him obviously as a finalist in the exploration category. Now, unfortunately, Nadia Ali, one of the finalists in this category, is working in a remote location at the moment and doesn't have access to internet. So she won't be able to join us in person. But we are able to see a selection of her beautiful images.
Wow. Look at those. This is one of my favourite things about this category. You get to see the real breadth of beauty in someone's work, don't you? It's fantastic.
Absolutely. It's a body of work taken over the course of a career. And I think what I love about Nadia's work is the vibrancy and variation in that body of work.
Yeah. Brilliant stuff, Nadia. And I'm very excited to say that we are actually joined now by the other two finalists, Henley and Shane. Hello to you both. Hello.
Hello.
Great to see you both. Thank you both for sharing your wonderful portfolios. Henley, I'm going to come to you first, if that's all right. Firstly, what drives you as an ocean photographer?
It's really a love of being underwater. You know, I was a diver long, long before I was a photographer. And so it's all about trying to transmit what I feel and see when I'm underwater, I suppose, and try to share that with people who perhaps aren't able to go to the places that I go.
Fantastic. And moving on to you, Shane, you're a Canadian photographer based in the Bahamas at the moment. Tell us a little bit about your photography journey and what you're doing there at the moment.
Well, thank you. I find that it's at least for me, pretty well impossible to fully capture the beauty of the ocean. So I just go into the water and hope to do the best I can, show something interesting, something special, and then show it to people. And hopefully that translates into them appreciating and loving the ocean and caring for it and hopefully doing what they can to protect it.
Certainly does.
Absolutely. Well, fantastic. And congrats to all three of our finalists again. The judges found this category almost impossible to separate the top three. Such is the quality and beauty of their work. But obviously that is exactly what they had to do. And the results are as follows. In third place is Shane Gross.
Congratulations,
to you, Shane. In second,
thank you, guys.
In second place is Henley Spears. Congratulations to you, Henley.
Fantastic, Henley.
Which of course means the winner of the Collective Portfolio Award is Nadia Ali. So congratulations to Nadia. Obviously a real shame she couldn't be here this evening, but she has left us this message.
Wow, thank you so much. I'm incredibly honored to have won the Ocean Collective Portfolio Award this year. For those of you who are looking at the portfolio, you're looking at some of my best work taken over the last 8 years, as I actually started taking photos underwater in 2012. The animals that you see in these photos fuel my creativity and give purpose to my life, as I'm incredibly passionate about educating people from all over the world about the animals that call our oceans home. What I'm most excited about with this award is the opportunity to work with Sea Legacy over the next year. I hope to make even more conservation content and share it with you, share it with the world, all in an effort to help our oceans be a safer and cleaner place.
Big congratulations to you, Nadia. Amazing work and an incredible opportunity provided by Sea Legacy 2.
Now, on to the last award of the night. It's the award of the night. The Ocean Photographer of the Year. This award recognizes the three most compelling or beautiful images submitted across all award categories. Images that connected with and captivated the judges like no others.
The competition was fierce. Bearing in mind, these three images were picked from more than 3,000 submissions. And I can tell you there was some fiery debate amongst the judging panel regarding which photograph ultimately came out on top, because there can, of course, only be one winner.
To introduce the award and to tell us a little bit about their journey and commitment to making tonight happen, here's Kieran Haslam from Princess Yachts.
So here we are. We're in the final stages before we find out who the Ocean Photographer of the Year will be. Now, there were so many entries and we're so proud. All 3,000 of us from here in Plymouth at Princess Yachts are so delighted with not just the entries, but the ability to raise awareness of the underwater world and the ocean, which is, after all, our playground. Many years ago, Princess officially collaborated with the Marine Conservation Society as the first luxury yacht company in the world to do so. It put us on a course to look at our environmental impact and what we can do to raise as much awareness about protecting the ocean as possible. Partnering with Oceanographic magazine was a very crucial stage in that process and in that commitment. And now seeing the first Ocean Photography Awards with the incredible entries is just a real honor. So from all of us here at Princess Yachts, a huge congratulations to everyone who participated and to the Ocean Photographer of the Year.
Unfortunately, all three of our finalists today are out of range, but no doubt they're busy creating more beautiful ocean imagery. They have, however, all sent us a pre-recorded video of their thoughts. So let's get to it. In third place is Magnus Lundborg with his beautiful image of a rare white southern right whale in the waters off Patagonia.
Hi, everybody. Magnus Lundborg here from the west coast of Sweden. My submission to the Ocean Photography Awards is a photo of a white southern right whale. I took this photo in the coastal waters of Patagonia in Argentina. But actually, I went there to raise awareness of another species. The eastern population of the North Atlantic right whales is more or less completely extinct. Several decades of overfishing and whaling has completely wiped them out. So in order to show people the giants that used to swim in the North Sea, I packed my fins and camera and I traveled to Patagonia, and it felt like going back in time. After a couple of days, we encountered a beautiful and curious white calf. And this is probably the biggest moment of my career.
I'm not surprised, and it's a beautiful, beautiful image. Okay, in second place, we have Sasha Specker for his delicate image of a surfer between two realms.
My name is Sasha Specker. I finished overall runner-up Ocean Photographer of the Year. This image behind me here is the one that I submitted. I felt it gave a new and different perspective not many of us are used to, and it put me in an environment that is challenging and allows me to express different ways of viewing something like surfing that all of us are so familiar with. So thank you for having me on board, and it has been an absolute honor and privilege to be amongst my peers in this final selection.
And congratulations to Sasha. So finally, the one we've all been waiting for, an image the judges have chosen as the top submission to the Ocean Photography Awards 2020. The winner of the Ocean Photographer of the Year is Nadia Ali for her stunning image of an aggregation of mobular rays in Mexico.
Thank you so much for honoring me with the Ocean Photographer of the Year award. I know there were so many amazing entries, and I was absolutely humbled and stunned when I found out that I had won. I'm most excited to work with Sea Legacy over the next year in my residency, which was a part of my collective portfolio award, and create even more conservation content and share that content with you guys in the world in hopes of raising more awareness for our oceans and the many plights that it faces. So I want to end this video with a short story, and I hope this short story and little bit of information about myself inspires one person. If I inspire one person out there, that's cool. My job is done for today. Okay, so here we go. In 2012, I started taking photos underwater. Obviously, that was just 8 years ago. That's not too long ago. So I headed over to Backscatter in Monterey. I got my Canon 5D Mark II. I got a housing and some strobes. I ended up going to Bonaire as my first dive trip. And for the first 5 days of that dive trip, I could not create an exposure. All of my photos were black. I just couldn't figure out what I was doing with the lights and my settings. But I kept at it, and by the end of the trip, I was able to at least not have black photos completely. I could actually maybe get some light into my photos with the strobe positions. But I persevered. I left that trip. I persevered. I went on many, many other trips. I learned on YouTube. I learned from other underwater photographers. I just kept at it. And eventually I got to the point where I feel like I acquired some really good skill sets for taking photos underwater. Now, what is the lesson here? The lesson is perseverance and willpower and drive. If you want to be an underwater photographer, if you want to be an underwater videographer, a storyteller, or get into conservation, there is absolutely nothing stopping you but yourself. If you have the will and the drive, you can do it. Here I am, a perfect example. I started 2012, it's 2020, I'm Ocean Photographer of the Year, and that's the story. So I hope it inspires you or someone you know, and I hope you follow my adventures with Sea Legacy and Oceanographic, and we'll see you online soon.
Well, a huge congratulations to you, Nadia. The judges were mesmerized by your photograph, and I'm sure you'll go on to inspire many more people. So that's it for this year's awards. Thank you to all of you who have tuned in to share this time with us to appreciate the wonderful work being done by so many ocean photographers from around the world. If you'd like to take a closer look at some of the images you've seen this evening, please visit oceanphotographyawards.com, where all of tonight's images can be found, along with additional information on the photographs and photographers. If you're a lover of seeing beautiful ocean photography in high quality print, like Will and his team at Oceanographic magazine, you'll also find a link at the bottom of the website to the Ocean Photography Awards 2020 annual. It's a gorgeous coffee table book featuring all of tonight's 100 images. Or you can visit oceanphotographyawards.shop.
A huge thank you to everyone involved in bringing this evening together. To our partner Sea Legacy, particularly the judges for their passion and conviction with which they approached their task. And of course, a huge thank you for the amazing and critical work they do for the ocean with their own cameras. Thank you to Kieran and his team at Princess Yachts, without whom these awards simply could not have happened. Truly a luxury brand with a big blue heart. And of course, a huge thanks to the amazing team at MCC GLC who have helped bring this evening to life, doing amazing work as we transition from a physical event to something in the digital space due to the pandemic. Thank you to our Cornish friends, Finisterre and Fourth Element, for the ocean adventure and exploration kits they have put together for all of tonight's winners.
Most importantly, thank you to all of this year's photographers, to every one of you who entered and took the time to share your ocean story with us. We'll be sharing news of 2021's awards in the new year.
So please do sign up to our newsletter or follow us on Instagram to get that information as it's released. And in the meantime, congratulations again to all of tonight's winners. We'll see you next year.